I like all animals. In general, I like every animal. The way I see robotics is an enabling tool for me to understand better animal behavior. My name is Maurizio Porfiri and I am a professor in mechanical engineering at NYU Polytechnic School of Engineering. My lab is called the Dynamical Systems Lab and we are focused on underwater robotics. Some of our facility is related to building robots. Then we have facilities for behavioral studies. And we have a dedicated facility to learn about testing the robots with the animals. I do enjoy being here, so I'm here maybe 100 hours a week, so I must enjoy it.
Tell me a little bit more about zebrafish in general.
So zebrafish is used quite a bit as an animal model for learning about anxiety and fear. People are using it extensively as if it was a rat. They have placed this animal in conditions where they would face a predator. And then by changing the fraction of alcohol that is administered in the water, they would look at how the animal would interact with the predator. The problem with this experiment is that the predator sometimes doesn't behave the way it should be. So what we wanted to do was replace the predator with a robot that would always behave the same with the animals. The use of robots can be very, very helpful in developing experiments which are highly customizable and repeatable to minimize the number of experimental subjects. Our robot is quite simple. They are all printed with a three-dimensional printer.
So this is where you make the zebrafish, correct?
That's correct. So what we do is we look at pictures of live animals and then we utilize them to make computer-aided design, which we input to a machine like this. And then we utilize this machine to print the outer shell of this robot. It's also open source and we make it available to the community.
Right now we're making a robot and we're not even doing anything. It's going right now and we're making a robot. That's pretty cool.
Yes, it's very cool. In the lab we feel like home, so I'm very selective with the students. I'm very careful of taking people who are very, very committed and they care about their work. So at the end it's a very nice environment and very, very friendly.
My name is Paul Pham Duy. I designed some of the robotic fish here in Dr. Porfiri's lab.
Sorry. I'm holding here a 3D printed iPod touch controlled zebrafish robot. It was designed here by Paul, and I have a separate iPod touch app designed by other researchers in the lab. I can control the fish's steering, I can control the amplitude, and I can control the frequency. So I'm gonna take it for a test drive. It's super intuitive. All I have to do is, it's like playing a game pretty much. So I'm being a pest right now. I'm just kind of trying to attack a smaller fish. This is the Commodore and we're gonna take a look at what is inside of this thing.
We have a wide range of robots. We have also bigger robots which we plan to deploy in the wild in the future. So what we can do is we can make predators which can condition animal behavior. So for example, we may want to drive our fish away from danger if there were an oil spill, for example. There was no research before at least to the best of my knowledge, there was not much research focused on influencing fish behavior utilizing robots. And people are starting to look into this technology for doing experiments in their own laboratories. One very recent review looking at zebrafish as a model organism for autism was actually emphasizing our work with robots. For us, it's very important that our work impacts as many people as possible, so we are trying to somehow maximize the potential of our approach for use in other laboratories.